The trash to energy plant in downtown Biddeford will soon cease to exist. The city voted to purchase the MERC plant for more than $6.5 million and then tear it down within a year. Tonight, plans are already in the works to redevelop the old vacant mills surrounding the MERC property. At News 8's Jim Keithley joins us now with a glimpse at some of those plans. Jim?
Well, Tracy, first off, since day one, 1987, people wondered why anyone would build a trash incinerator in the middle of a downtown, but they did. And after 25 years of fighting, it appears MERC's days are numbered. Now, local developers say this is the news they've been waiting for and expect a wave of future development once MERC is gone.
They left in 2009. That was owned by Carl Icahn.
Nobody is more excited about MERC's demise than developer Doug Sanford. He owns more than 1 million square feet of old mill space in 17 buildings around the MERC plant. He's already developed about 25% of the space into apartments like this one where he lives. And there are light manufacturing businesses coming all the time, like Hyperlight Mountain Gear. They make super light backpacks in one of the commercial spaces here. More of this is what Sanford expects in the future. And he says with MERC gone, it opens up a floodgate of possibilities and opportunities.
It spins upon itself. So we see not only the manufacturing side, we have great space for that. We see office uses, we see residential uses, and an urban center that has the ability to grow in a sustainable, affordable fashion.
Saco Mayor Mark Johnston is among the original few who've been trying hard to shut down MERC since the plant spewed black ash back in 1988, a year after opening.
I got actively involved in Saco's politics, and MERC was always the agenda.
And now that it looks like the death of MERC, what's going through your mind this morning?
Joy, and fingers crossed, hopefully that this whole process works out.
The plan is for the city to officially close on this deal in 3 months. The incinerator will stop operating next spring and the plant torn down sometime next fall. The company that owns MERC still needs to iron out permitting for its new landfill where Biddeford's trash will be sent.
Now, the smokestack will be all that remains once MERC is torn down. You see those cell phone antennas up there? Companies actually pay to rent space on that smokestack, generating $150,000 a year for the city of Biddeford. And so tonight, it seems most people think, at least, that MERC's demise will breathe new life into a community where they've been forced to smell trash for 2.5 decades. We're live in Biddeford, Jim Keithley, News 8.